Master of the Day, fellow Toastmasters, and distinguished guests, good evening to you all.
Good evening.
How many of you would like to lead a life without stress, happy? It seems all of us would like to lead a stress-free, happy, and harmonious life. A couple of years back, this thought came to me that I should lead a stress-free life for 100 years. I went to the doctor to consult. He said, he was stunned actually. And he said, you must be joking. You know where you are living? You are living in Dubai. You should not have these kind of long-term ambitions. He said, okay, so to reduce the stress, he gave some ideas. First one was, eat more vegetables and fruits. The second one was, exercise regularly. The third one was, enjoy life. The first one, as far as concerned, being a vegetarian, it was easy for me to adopt the first one. I started taking more vegetables and fruits as part of that. The second one, as far as concerned, exercise regularly, I started walking for 1 hour every day. And I also felt good, that energized, but it's only for some time. Because the scorching heat of summer and the humidity have started taking toll on me. And I conveniently postponed that one for winter. And the third one was how to live happy life. I went again back to the doctor to clarify. He said, try new thing in life. Try new thing in life or do things differently. I decided to do both during that year's vacation. It was 14th of July 2014 when I decided to enjoy my life completely. That was the day when Germany beat Argentina in the World Cup football. The match was absolute beauty, where the Argentinians played a poetic, creative, and almost mesmerizing style. Whereas the Germans, with their mechanical machine-like efficiency, high speed and attacking football. The match was a fitting final to the month-long festival of football. And we were, along with my friends, four of us, were in football crazy Goa, in Goa. And the match was absolute beauty, and then the wonder boy, Maria Gortz, scored the goal, and then Germany won. After the match, we all headed for the beach, where we stayed in the resort, which is the distance between the resort and the beach is hardly less than 100 meters, under the aqua. And the evening, we headed for the beach, where we sat and watched the sea. Calm, and the waves were crashing onto the shores. The sun began to set off and quiet. It was sitting sleepy and unhurried back. The view of the red hot sun going down the blue ocean was absolute tranquil in the light. I thought it was enough. But Goa also known for beautiful beaches and variety of beers. But Goa also provides an experience of natural beauty and explorer's delight. Goa provides one of the exhilarating trekking terrains for those who want to explore. The treacherous terrains and the deceitful jungle, forest, wildlife gives us one of the most wonderful experience for those who explore through the Dusagar Falls. And we decided to explore that exactly. We started our journey from a famous place called Devil's Canyon. canyon on the way, brought through some of the breathtaking views of canyon, and take us to the one of the most wonderful lush green forest, and provide you with a view of Virgin Goa. On the way to the peak, we also encountered one of our beautiful flowers, wild flowers, which only I have seen in movies like Avatar and all, that kind of flowers. Beautiful birds, colorful butterflies, and various other species. But the most important thing on the way, most captivating one, is the one which is called Fishing Pond. This pond, which is unique because of its rhythmic bubbles. Sitting on the shore of the pond, watching that, you feel that, you know, the mother nature is playing music and these bubbles are dancing to her tunes. It was one of the most memorable holiday experience for me. One thing, it was tiring, mentally, physically tiring, but mentally refreshed. Stress-free trip for me. One thing I noticed, learned from this, that it was the best stress buster is to travel new places and enjoy the new experience. Whenever I am stressed out, I still close my eyes and recollect that wonderful, wonderful experience to refresh myself and energize. I conclude my speech with a quote from St. Augustine. World is a big book, and the person who has not traveled has only read one page. Quote to the question.